You're watching Reality Check. In Karnataka, as the age of Kumaraswamy ends and the age of Yeddyurappa begins once again, we will look at whether this is now going to be a Mazboot Sarkar or a Majboor Sarkar. Because even though the BJP managed to win that cliffhanger finally fairly comfortably in the assembly, the fact is that it is still very much on a razor's edge when it comes to the numbers. But for the moment, the man of the moment is on the screen, B.S. Yeddyurappa, the BJP's war horse, now his fourth time as Chief Minister of Karnataka, being surrounded by his supporters, the BJP celebrating as they once again seize, add one more state to their kitty. In the game of states, they add one more, the Congress loses. The Congress and its allies lose one more state. The culmination of what turned out in the end to be a test match. It could have been a one-day match. The Congress and its partner, the JDS, turned it into a five-day drama, finally ending in a vote of confidence with the Speaker insisting that it be concluded today. Let's listen to what Yeddyurappa had to say moments after the trust vote.
It is the victory of the democracy. People were fed up with the Kumaraswamy government. I want to assure the people of Karnataka, new era of development.
Okay, all right. So here in the studio with us, we have Mr. Bhaskar Ghosh of the BJP, Tehsin Poonawala, political analyst, supporter of the Congress. They were just congratulating each other. I don't know if you want to reconstruct that for our cameras once again. You were just shaking his hand very honorably. We don't want to do that now the cameras are on, or you were happy to do that?
Vajpayee ji said, matbhed honi chahiye, manbhed nahi.
Achha, okay, also joining us, Syed Abbas.
Vajpayee ji ye bhi bole the, chote man se koi bade kaam nahi karte.
Achha, okay.
Aaj bade man se hum bade kaam kar rahe hain.
Achha, bada kaam kar rahe hain, ye to abhi pata chalega. But Syed Abbas, leader of the JDS, also joining us. Syed Abbas, let me just start with you. In hindsight, do you think that this entire coalition of yours, which some believed was an unholy alliance from the beginning in Karnataka, was it a mistake?
Well, Srinivas, firstly, I'm a supporter of the JDS and Congress, a political analyst, not the leader. And now coming to the question that you've asked, what happened in Karnataka is unfortunate.
Was it a mistake? Was it a mistake, you think, to begin with? They were never meant, this was never going to work.
I wouldn't say it's a mistake, because we, the people of Karnataka, never voted for a single largest party to form the government. Therefore, it was a fractured mandate.
Right.
So equally, every voter here in Karnataka is responsible. Also, now coming to from day one, Yeddyurappa ji, on record, the most corrupt chief minister during his tenure, went to jail.
Okay.
Also, now coming to this front, have done anything and everything in the interest of the people of Karnataka.
Let me come to the corruption.
The power.
Let me come to the corruption. Let me come to all of that in a second. I just wanted your answer about whether you thought it was a mistake. You said it wasn't. Tehsin Poonawala, as we now get live pictures from Raj Bhavan, where apparently first Mr. Kumaraswamy has gone to submit his resignation, and presumably where Mr. Yeddyurappa will be going to stake his claim. Tehsin, your quick one-word answer. Was this a mistake to begin with, this alliance?
Mistake, because I don't have 25 crores in Supreme Court judges. I said in Yeddyurappa ji's tapes, which he admitted on the floor of the House.
But otherwise, politically, a mistake?
I don't have 25 crores or judges.
Okay, you didn't answer that question.
I didn't
have.
I'd like to answer that.
In which I asked it. But
I'm very tempted.
Bhaskar Ghosh.
To quote unquote.
Yeah. Bhaskar Ghosh, I want to ask you a different question. Net, net, how much did this entire operation cost you? What's the total bill?
Well, if
plus
I
GST, add GST, to
of course.
This is not a GST taxed operation.
It would be
off the books. But anyway, what's the average cost of this whole operation?
Before I go to the
costing,
the financial aspect of it, as far as your questions, let me quote unquote two famous quotations, a debut quotation by Kumaraswamy, and a concluding quotations by D.K. Sipkumar.
Okay.
I'm talking about, you're talking about,
because yes, yeah, heard,
within half a second.
We've had five days of speeches.
We are half a second. I'm not speaking. And debut quote of Kumaraswamy was that I am having a jar of poison. I am taking a jar of poison.
Okay, that was the debut.
And the concluding quotation of D.K. Sivakumar was, all will die and maybe tonight we have extra two large pegs.
Okay.
Now the time, so the but entire coalition.
They've declared dry. No, today is a dry day in Bangalore.
That is why. No, so, but dry for others. The coalition from the day one was basically for Kumaraswamy a poison and for Sivakumar a glass of poison.
Pegs. Two large pegs. What about the bill?
Now it
what
was dwindling between these two.
What about
now
the bill? Cost. What about the bill for the BJP?
The cost. The cost of BJP is the time frame since we got the mandate of the people of 105.
No, this operation.
From that day, the man hours. The whole time we have spent, and I asked Kumaraswamy that the amount of money he has spent for whole circus, you know.
No, I'm asking is the cost. You because I'm
this
just
is the cost
you.
Of BJP.
No, this is I'm the cost asking of you a BJP. Different question.
The can whole, I, can, no, the no, whole no, money which has been spent,
no, I'm asking
the
you,
time
can I come
that
in?
Has been spent
can
of
I come
the,
in?
Of the public,
yes, yes,
of
I've
the people,
I've heard you.
That is the cost of BJP.
Okay, can I ask you, just a second, before everyone gets in, if you go by the numbers that were mentioned on the floor of the house, that it was roughly about 30 crores per MLA, so if you took about 18 MLAs, 30 times 18, roughly 600 crores, throw in the private jets, the hotel costs and all that. Is that about a reasonable number, Bhaskar Ghosh, 600 crores?
First, BJP today has owned and his own strength of 105. We have not taken anyone's help.
No, I'm talking, about jet, the, I'm talking about the 18 friends who helped by resigning from
no,
the floor
that
of
is,
the house. That's why
see,
you
that
won.
Is the Congress. They cannot help their own okay. soldiers. That is not my responsibility.
Okay.
You cannot throw away your inefficiency on us, right? Or your inability I towards mean, us, right? Whenever in Goa, I will ask how much money we have paid in Goa for getting 10 Congress.
You tell me.
No,
you tell.
You didn't tell us. Please.
The nation, the nation wants
yours.
To know.
The you mean my pay.
Nation wants to know.
We only can vote and quote entire Goa. They have told we cannot now show our loyalty
okay.
towards
let me move. Can I bring in Sagarika Ghosh? Can I bring in Sagarika Ghosh? Sagarika Ghosh, thanks for being here on the show. If I can just pull up, Sagarika Ghosh, the visuals of the swearing-in of Kumaraswamy a year ago. And if you can pull those visuals up, because that was a big moment for the opposition. It was kind of presided over by all the stalwarts of the anti-Modi coalition. It brought together Mamata Banerjee and the left. It brought together Mayawati and the Samajwadi Party. There are those visuals up on the screen. So in a way, Sagarika, what we're seeing today is symbolic of the collapse of that.
Absolutely, Vasu. I think the situation that exists today was embedded in what happened in May 2018, when two enemies, actually, as you know, and I know, we've been there, we've traveled,
sure.
The JDS and Congress are at loggerheads. Siddaramaiah himself, no blood, love lost with Kumaraswamy.
Sure.
They came together in a kind of desperate move to keep the BJP out. Frankly, Kumaraswamy had no mandate to be chief minister. He had 37 seats in a house of 224.
Yes.
Congress had 78.
Yes.
They did not have a mandate. They came together in a desperate hurry to keep the BJP out. Now, when they came together, the contradictions within these two parties came to the fore.
Yeah.
The foot soldiers on the ground simply didn't get on the Vokaliga vote.
Yeah.
That they both relied on or even
yes.
went away from them.
Right.
You know, the kind of victory that the BJP got in the Lok Sabha, 25 out of 28 seats,
yeah.
obviously showed that the arithmetic, which the
had
JDS and
changed.
Congress was banking on,
yes.
did not deliver for them.
Yes.
So you see, once that rout happened in the Lok Sabha, the writing was on the wall. And I think what has happened, and you know, I've been saying this, you know, we've been talking about it, is that Siddaramaiah and sections of the Congress obviously wanted to break the alliance with the JDS. They didn't want to be with a losing proposition.
Right.
Because
so this
they
was a kind of internal
the
internal
contradictions
implosion.
Were too great.
So
the contradictions of this alliance were too great. It imploded. And of course, the BJP waiting to fish in troubled waters. But now, Vasu, I just want to say on a larger point, the BJP is now in power in 17 states. Once it's sworn in, power in 17 states.
Yes.
Congress in 4.5.
Yes.
So the Ashwamedh horse of the BJP is galloping from state to state to state.
Okay. Testing the point that this was, of course, there would be perhaps some kind of Operation Kamala dimension to this, but this was also partly a self-made crisis. That there were people like Siddaramaiah who were always waiting for this to fail.
Between the two Bengali stalwarts on my right and my left, ironically, the fact of the matter is simply this, that every single allegation with the Sagarika ji or Gosab is making, I would just say that if Siddaramaiah has done anything wrong, kindly investigate it and put it on front. He's saying that he wants those MLAs to come back. They are spending the money, but we have journalists who blame the Congress for it. It's like a typical school situation where I'm the bully, I'm getting bullied, and everybody's blaming me for getting bullied.
No, one at a time.
You say, okay, no, I have, no, 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 don't worry. You have all the institutions. You are saying
How many times you went to Supreme Court? The fact is that Mr. Kumaraswamy himself would come out and weep. Indicate that he was having a very rough time
of
with the Congress.
He had to cry.
This is not stuff that
of
you know.
And he was ready to resign today. He was ready to resign today.
Of course he was crying. Of course he had to cry. Why would he not cry? 25 crores is being accepted on the floor. You know,
I'm saying much before all this.
I'm talking about February 2019.
How much crore you spend on Supreme Court bill?
You know, on the floor of the House. Forget everything else. You know, on the floor of the House, when each individual MLA was being named, that you came up and you offered me 5 crores today.
They never got up and refused it. Not one of them refused it. Okay, Saidabas.
And I'm the victim here, not the...
Saidabas, would you say that as much as you could blame the Congress's own leadership for being sort of at war within, would you say that this is also a huge self-goal by the JDS? I mean, the JDS had a shot at trying to run a government... a good government, it just turned into a family affair.
Srinivasji,
how many family members are MPs, MLAs and ministers, well, ex-ministers in this current setup? Why don't you list them for us?
None, just one, and that is Prajwal from...
Hold on. Mr. Kumaraswamy, Chief Minister. Mr. Revanna is the PWD Minister.
Prajwal
is an MP. Mr. Deve Gowda is an MP.
You have to count on Congress
side
also.
MP and 3 MLAs.
Both are competing each other. Adding on to
the point you said, on a very lighter note, ISRO was very successful in launching Chandrayaan 2 on Moon. And the BJP, Yeddyurappa ji, was very successful in launching all the rebel MLAs in Mumbai. I wish it was Moon and not Mumbai. Nevertheless,
Sayyedji, I have a very question about it. You cannot hold your soldier you are blaming on Yeddyurappa, right?
No, sir.
What a shame.
It's a stretch.
What a shame.
It has been a
you are running a headless organization and you are accusing Yeddyurappa for doing that, right?
Every single central agency has been used. Income tax, threats on life. Independent Nagesh MLA released an audio tape where PA Santosh, Yeddyurappa's personal assistant Santosh, pairing him, literally taking on gunpoint all the way to Mumbai.
You know the point is,
Shukumarji saved my life.
Okay, Bhaskar, I have this question to you is that, okay, you've managed to come to power, but is this the way? When we keep hearing from the Prime Minister that we are now going to run a clean government, we are going to run corruption-free government, this the way to do it? Jor Tor, horse trading, buying and selling MLAs, resorts, private jets. I mean, what kind of signal are you sending to India and to Karnataka by forming a government like this?
If we have done it, then when Deep Shiv Kumar went to have a dialogue with their, these MLAs, they have refused even to talk to him. He has checked in the same hotel and he was
BJP
told,
rules
because been, I was
because
not allowed
been,
to
it has been made, their, made worth
because
their while
MLA
not to
has
talk to
complained
him.
Against him.
Because you have outbid DK Shivkumar.
No. How?
Yes.
How? Can you have a tangible evidence of outbid what? Because
BJP
the moment
state,
MLA do not
BJP
work.
BJP ruled police.
No, these MLA also, do not want to stay back in a party which is running as a headless organization for last 1 month.
Fine. Except when
Congress is confidence.
What about BJP? What about your claims of running a clean, corruption-free outfit when what has clearly happened in Karnataka has not happened without the trading of some kind of incentive?
Let me tell you one thing. Today, the BJP is now headed by Mr. Modi and Mr. Amit Shah. Mm-hmm. And now, when we take the power, when we take the charge of the state, Yes. Then you will understand that how we run the government without the corruption-free governments. Right? You cannot say that right.
Mr. Yeddyurappa's track record is before you.
Why is it not important?
So Congress is no corruption.
Say that as on today.
Say that I accept you. Say Congress is
first of all. As on today, how he act under the leadership of Mr. Narendra Modi, that is important.
Okay.
That is important.
I just want to, you know, the point you're making about Yeddyurappa, we also have to ask ourselves, how stable is this government going to be?
Yes.
The fact is, Mr. Yeddyurappa, in his first term, that government was a mess.
Yes.
He had to resign.
Midway,
now,
yes.
He's coming in with a lot of IOUs to a lot of people. The people who are going to jump on board are going to have a lot of expectations from Mr. Yeddyurappa.
Yes.
So is he going to be able to satisfy those expectations? You know, I wouldn't be surprised, Vasu, if the BJP, yes, forms the government with Mr. Yeddyurappa, but, you know, midway through, maybe it's got 4 years to go, the central leadership might just look for a change of guard. I mean, of course, at the end, it is now.
But I think that's a point which, let me come to you. Vivek Reddy also joining us on the phone line. Vivek Reddy, the same question asked Bhaskar Ghosh, that as now, because you won the vote and Mr. Yeddyurappa is coming to be chief minister, congratulations for that. But now you have to, in a sense, pay the bills for this entire business. What is that bill? Is there a number that you could share with us, Vivek Reddy?
Well, there is no bill.
100, 200, 300 crore?
The only reason this has occurred is because the central structure of the Congress has collapsed. And because of that, people don't want to stay back in Congress.
Who paid?
They are not parties with any hope, or they are not parties with any future.
Can I just ask you, who paid for the private jets to take the MLAs back and forth from Bombay, and who paid for their stay in Bombay? Who paid for that?
I think you should ask the independent MLAs.
I'm asking you. I'm just asking, you would not know. You're saying BJP didn't pick up any of those bills.
The world has seen.
No, how can BJP know?
The only person who can know is those independent MLAs. They went there because they wanted to be free from all trouble from the coalition partner. So why was Mr. Yeddyurappa's personal secretary escorting them into the private jet, Mr. Santosh? Yeah. Well, see, that single instance cannot be a reason to presume things, Vasu.
The most important thing is that they have migrated from a drowning ship.
Right.
Why have they migrated from the drowning ship? Because Congress is a party without hope today and there is no future.
I see.
Absolutely not.
Not only in Karnataka, it is happening in other places.
Right.
And it is very easy to say that this is happening for some other consideration. But also the primary consideration, the main only consideration is that Congress has lost its strength and vigor. And today the Congress is a weak party. And it was a drowning ship, so nobody wants to drown.
Okay, just a news update that the governor has accepted the resignation of Mr. Kumaraswamy and has asked him to continue as an alternative till as a caretaker until alternative arrangements are made. Number one. Number two, quickly, sorry, just another news update. Mayawati has expelled the sole BSP MLA from Karnataka, because she had asked him to come and vote for the coalition, but possibly he has not done that. He has perhaps sat this one out, and so she has expelled him. So yet another blow to the coalition, to the anti-BJP front, Syed Abbas. So this is literally collapsing before our eyes. Syed Abbas.
All thanks to, I'd like to say, the Bharatiya Janata Party, being from the state of Karnataka and a proud Kannadiga, let me clearly state this, irrespective of all the politics, today we have seen BJP redefining resort politics, hotel politics, plane chartered plane politics.
You were the inventor of this politics. You couldn't keep your house together. Remember in the 80s and 90s, what you have done.
You couldn't keep, you know, one thing I just want to say.
I do agree. I do agree with you, Srinivas ji.
It's not the first time.
There are certainly differences in the
coalition. I just want to say,
it's bound to be, certainly. I do admit and agree on your show today. But the BJP has played every single dirty trick in that dirty tricks department, which has been highly activated in the state of Karnataka.
Okay, how long you'll prevaricate? One second.
How long you'll prevaricate?
One second.
Just a second.
Let me just say this, that when you look at the people, Tehseen, and Syed Abbas, the people who left you this time, we're talking about Mr. Vishwanath, who was the working president of the JDS. Mm. He left. There were MLAs from the Congress who left.
Speaker has given ample
who
time.
Who have been MLAs five times. These are hardcore Congress MLAs. These are hardcore. Just a second.
You can't float like this.
No, at least, and allow me to complete the question. I'm saying these are leaders of both parties who are not the conventional usual suspects whom the BJP was nibbling away at and who could be sort of, you could say, vulnerable, susceptible to various loaves and fishes. This is some very core leadership, veterans, members of the party. So something goes beyond Tehseen just saying Operation Kamala or this or that, right? Something is not, all is not well, clearly.
I don't speak for the JDS. I have no connection with them.
Congress.
But Mr. Reddy, Ramalinga Reddy, absolutely came back and voted. That's point one. The people in the resort.
13 others in.
That the 13 people in the resort were all first-time MLEs. You may cross-check that. None of them were second-time MLEs. Now, I agree with this one premise of yours, Srinivasan, that the Congress needs to see who it gives ticket to. And I go back to one advice that I keep giving the Congress. Go to tried and trusted people, not to new people, because these people are people who are...
If anyone is left.
But I love...
That's, by the way, Kumaraswamy giving his resignation to Governor Vajubhai Wala. Yes, go ahead.
Absolutely. The same governor who gave up his seat for Modi ji, so Modi ji could get elected. So he'll do what Modi ji
says. The same governor who acted as a BJP agent here in Karnataka.
But I want to end by one point.
What about speaker?
I love every time you ask the BJP, whether it's Reddy Saab or Ghosh Saab, any question, the only answer they give, and I've heard this time, Nagar Srinivasan, is Congress did this in the 70s, the 80s, the 90s. So you should just tell us New India is all about what Mrs. Indira Gandhi did. You should tell us that and we would have seen.
Why do you repeat? How is your justification about what Congress did? I am saying
Congress was immoral, wrong, unethical, and what they done. So I would say the same thing.
Okay, no one can hear anybody. One second.
It's an anti-defection law. The Supreme Court. The Supreme Court. Instead of implementing a law, gives an interim judgment. An interim judgment?
We're not channels I don't want to name.
I apologize. I understand this is not a republic of nonsense. I totally agree on that.
One at a time. I just want to say, Sagarika, the point is that Rahul Gandhi is not even here.
Exactly.
He's supposed to be...
I was about to make that point.
London? America, just a second.
Just one second.
He's not here. He didn't come back to Sheila Dixit last night.
Yeah, you've really acquired lung power in the years that I've known you. I think we need to also look at what's happening to the Congress. And I think what Mr. Vivek Reddy is saying has some merit in it.
Yes.
That the fact is that the Congress is imploding. The center has... gone, the high command has eroded.
Yes.
So clearly the regional satraps like Siddaramaiah feel that they don't owe anything to the high command anymore. They might as well fend for themselves. Venugopal, by the way, who went there?
Who is now the main political point person for the Congress.
Yes.
This is a state he's in charge of. Is what has happened.
And Ghulam Nabi Azad went there. But they obviously, you know, the Congress is at sixes and sevens. I mean, and it's the same story everywhere. Even in Maharashtra, if you look at Vasu, they've appointed a president, but they've appointed five working presidents. So the Congress is in chaos. The center cannot hold. Naturally, the situation is that every state unit is panicking and they're obviously jumping ship.
We are literally out of time. I just want everyone, last comments. I'm coming to you. Syed, I'm coming to you on last comments from everybody, starting with you, Bhaskar Ghosh. Make a prediction for Karnataka. What is, you think, going to be the first thing that Mr. Yeddyurappa is going to do when he becomes chief minister?
See, the first and foremost thing, anyone who is not Yeddyurappa only, anyone who could be taking the chair, we have a very clear mandate of 105 and we have very clear manifesto also. In the manifesto, whatever we have promised, the prime responsibility of the chair or the persons and the cabinet be to implement in shortest possible time and give a justice, not the breach of trust with the people, but give a justice to the people.
Number one priority will be, quickly.
The fact is that today we missed Rahul Gandhi. When Rahul Gandhi was president, he managed to have this alliance. He should realize the value, and political commentators, instead of attacking Rahul Gandhi, should value him.
Syed Abbas?
Yes. The final point I'd like to make is, we the people of Karnataka certainly deserve a stable government.
Okay.
It is very unfortunate from about 15 to 20 days running without governance. When we are facing water crisis, drought crisis, farmer suicide, we certainly deserve. And Yeddyurappa ji, I'd like to end with a shiny.
Okay. We have to end.
Andheron ka jigar cheer kar noor aayega. Tum ho Firaun, to Musa bhi zarur aayega.
Okay. All right. Well, let's end with these visuals, which tell you the story of the journey of this government from that star started swearing in a year ago, now to an ignominious collapse 1 year later. Take away from those images what you will, because they tell you probably everything you need to know about Indian politics right now. That's it on Reality Check. Thanks for watching. Good night.